What is an aural hematoma? An aural hematoma, also known as an ear hematoma, is a blood blister that develops between the skin and cartilage of the pinna. It's very common in dogs who are prone to ear infections, especially if they have floppy ears rather than ears that stand straight up. The condition occurs when trauma or an injury to the ear flap causes the small blood vessels inside the pinna to break and leak internally, resulting in a blood-filled swelling. Before I move on with the video, I want to ask you a simple question. Do you want to train your dog for any basic commands like sit and stay? Do you want to stop any of the behavioral problems of your dog like pooping inside the house, biting, jumping, or barking? If your answer is yes, please grab the free dog training secrets guide in which I have disclosed the deepest dog training secrets that professional dog trainers don't want you to know about. These training secrets would help you have a well-behaved, super intelligent, smart and obedient dog without spending hours in training him or her. The Secret Training Technique ebook is available for free only for a limited time. So go and grab it before it's too late. Link to the free ebook and training videos is in the description below. What does an aural hematoma look like? With an ear hematoma, your dog's ear flap will be swollen. If the lesion is confined to just one part of the pinna, the swelling may be small. For larger hematomas, the whole ear flap will be engorged, and the weight of the collection of blood may cause the ear flap to droop and hang lower than usual. An ear hematoma may feel squishy or taut to the touch. More than likely, your pup will object to you touching it, since the pressure can be painful. What causes aural hematomas? In almost all cases, some sort of trauma or injury is to blame. That's what causes the blood vessels between the ear cartilage and skin to break and leak. The most common type of ear flap trauma is from a dog repeatedly scratching their ear and shaking their head, due to an ear infection, allergic skin condition, ear mites, or a foreign body lodged in the ear canal. For that reason, your vet will take a close look inside your pet's ears. Aural hematomas can also develop from an accidental bump or injury to the ear flap. For example, this could happen during vigorous play, if your pup runs through bushes and their ear gets scraped by a sharp branch, or following a bite wound on the ear flap from another dog or a wild animal. Less commonly, health conditions that cause blood clotting abnormalities can also lead to a blood pocket formation in the ear flap. How is an aural hematoma diagnosed? Diagnosis is usually straightforward. The appearance and feel of the ear tell your vet a lot, especially if an ear infection is also present. In some cases, your veterinarian may take a needle sample to confirm there is blood in the swollen area, and to rule out other conditions that would need a different treatment, for example, a mass on the skin or swelling due to a bee sting. What is the treatment for an aural hematoma? A surgery is usually best because it can provide a permanent solution for the hematoma, and surgery has the best chance of preventing scars. Additionally, it's crucial to treat the underlying cause of the aural hematoma, so if your dog has an ear infection, that needs to be addressed, too. Is surgery really necessary? Can't hematomas be drained or heal on their own? If the hematoma is mild/small, or if surgery is not a treatment option, for example, if your pet isn't healthy enough for anesthesia, your veterinarian may try draining the hematoma with a large needle. However, this is not ideal because aural hematomas usually come back without a surgery. Also, if blood clots are already present inside the blood pocket, it will be difficult, maybe even impossible, for your vet to remove the swelling via a needle. The blood clots will be too big to fit through the needle. In some cases, particularly with very small hematomas, your vet may even recommend waiting and monitoring. But these small hematomas are much less common than the big ones. What's recovery like after aural hematoma surgery? Your pup may be sore for a few days following surgery, but your veterinarian will give you pet-safe medications for pain and inflammation, as well as antibiotics if needed. You'll also receive an Elizabethan collar for your dog. This will prevent them from ear scratching, reducing the risk of inflammation, bleeding, or accidentally removing their sutures too soon. And, most pets will have a bandage on their head to help protect the ear and place gentle pressure. Your vet will let you know how to monitor and care for your pet at home after surgery, and when to come back in for rechecks and for suture removal. Do you want to have a well-behaved, obedient and calm pet dog without spending hours in training him? Check out the first link in the description and download the Secret Training Technique Guide absolutely free. It is available for free only for a limited period of time. Thanks for watching the video. Comment below if you liked the video. Please subscribe to the channel Aural Paws Training if you are serious about training and grooming your dog. Also, join our Facebook group where you get all the solutions to your daily doggy problems.